In the darkest depths of the Stygian Abyss lies the Slasher of Veils, an ancient and unbelievably powerful demon, accidentally summoned by two brothers, Tybal and Garamond. During their experiments in planar travel, the Slasher's arrival shattered the veil between worlds, unleashing a force so malevolent that no mortal weapon or spell could banish it. Although the brothers managed to trap it within the Chamber of Virtue, its presence remained a constant threat to Britannia, its influence slowly corrupting the world around it. The Slasher, with its insidious whispers, preyed upon Tybal's weaker will, offering him power and immortality in exchange for betrayal. Overcome by greed and madness, Tybal murdered his brother, Garamond, who had devised a plan to trap the demon in its own dimension. The Slasher, however, remained imprisoned in the chamber, its influence growing as the bonds of virtue weakened over time. Now, the Slasher of Veils waits in its dark prison, a force of pure destruction whose power continues to build. Adventurers who enter the Chamber of Virtue do so not to defeat the creature, but to survive its terrifying wrath. Facing the Slasher is the ultimate test of courage, and those who dare must contend with a being that seeks nothing less than the unraveling of reality itself. The build I'm using is a standard melee warrior that is similar to a Sampire, but healing is used in place of Bushido. On Yule Alive, the time delay of bandages is 2 seconds. I have crafted basic skill bonus jewelry that doesn't require high-intensity materials, combined with the skill bonuses on the Soldier's Metal Trinket and Hephaestus Shield, to achieve the desired skill milestones. My performance in terms of hit chance increase, defense chance increase, and damage increase are all at their cap through the use of imbued weapons, jewelry, and armor, combined with a few relatively easy-to-acquire items. Highly specialized gear and high-intensity materials are minimal, although this is not to say better gear can't be added. The gear I use is almost all available through the Blackthorn's Dungeon reward system or via imbuing. Besides an automatic healing script, I have Chivalry's Consecrate Weapon always up, which converts the equipped weapon to the opponent's lowest elemental resistance. I also have scripts to move to and attack the closest enemy for both primary and secondary weapon skills, and these are the only scripts I use. I experimented with an automatic remove curse script, which works, but I found it was interrupted by other scripts and it is easier to just use a regular keybind. My weapon of choice is the katana due to its low stamina requirement to reach the fastest swing speed, and its desirable armor ignore move. It has double strike as well, but I find armor ignore has more consistent damage output. My second weapon is the radiant scimitar, which has the whirlwind move, perfect for dealing with groups. The whip is another great choice, although requiring higher stamina for the highest swing speed, available via the tinkering BOD rewards, perhaps only on Yule Alive. I don't use Divine Fury, as I've already reached my performance caps, and its reduction to defense chance and increased mana cost is not desirable. I obviously don't use Bushido's Lightning Strike either, as I don't have Bushido, and items make up the hit chance increase benefits anyway. It is possible to use the Swordsmanship Mastery Onslaught, but it needs to be cast just after Consecrate Weapon to be fully effective, and I found it too difficult to combine with the other running scripts and did just fine without it. As far as damage increase, I imbue the highest level possible on my weapon without having to use special materials, combined with a few other items and the mastery buff to achieve the 100% item and buff cap. I then strategically use Chivalry's Enemy of One to gain an additional 82% and use a Slayer weapon wherever possible. If I'm not using the Slayer property, I add hit lower defense, which is effective. To add to my survivability, I use Necromancy's Vampiric Embrace to leech life as I do damage and have life leech on all my weapons. High-intensity materials are not required for decent benefits, but it is an option for the future. An issue my character does have is running out of mana. To improve this, I changed my race to Elf through the Human to Elf quest, which gives me an extra 30 mana, as well as increased energy resistance, and tried to minimize the spells I cast to just Consecrate Weapon and the occasional Remove Curse. I have imbued Studded Leather with mana increase and lower mana cost, and have 300 points of melee skills, including 105 in Lumberjacking, to reduce the mana cost of combat moves such as Armor Ignore. I also imbue Hit Mana Leech on all weapons and have as much gear as possible that increases intelligence and mana regeneration, including regeneration gained from Vampiric Embrace, but I do get mana drained as I don't have resisting spells. I also initially had issues with spells such as Remove Curse being interrupted, and with higher faster casting and fast cast recovery this improved. I used the Night Eyes artifact, which is also acquirable through Blackthorn's dungeon rewards as an alternative. The Holy Grail Tabard is another option with the downside of low durability. The Hephaestus Shield has faster casting, which is acquired from Korra the Sorceress, and there is also the City buff. This build is nothing breakthrough or innovative, and anyone interested in melee characters would probably come to the same conclusion. The difference is mainly the 2-second bandage healing on Yo Alive, which makes the warrior's life a much more enjoyable experience, creating more options and potential experiences in the world of Ultima Online.
Yeah. Thank you.